So good morning and welcome to Hinkley Point C. I'm Stuart Crooks, the Managing Director of this fantastic project. Today you join us at a momentous occasion as we celebrate the pour of the common raft here in the nuclear island. We're pouring this concrete in the midst of one of the world's most difficult crises, but we've managed to implement a working pattern to keep our people safe, to keep our community safe, and enable the project to progress in a safe and consistent manner. And to that I owe a great debt of gratitude to all of the workers working here at HPC and the support we've received from the local community in implementing many changes to social distancing to enable this milestone to happen. Amongst the measures we've introduced over the last few months to keep people safe are issues like social distancing on buses. So a bus that would normally take 40 or 50 people is limited to 15 people. We've relied on more buses and more bus drivers, but also protecting those bus drivers learning from the industry by making sure that they are safe in their work. Everyone who comes to site has to be temperature monitored at this park and rides, and by Friday this huge concrete pour of 9,000 cubic metres will be complete, marking the J0 milestone that we set out some 4 years ago. It's a great privilege to be here to recognise the efforts of our people in delivering a milestone, delivering a target on exactly the date we predicted over 4 years ago before the final investment decision. That's been made possible because of the amount of effort of our people, but also the significance of the learning that we've put into this project. On Unit 1, a few hundred metres to my left, only 11 months ago did we pour J0. On this unit, we've demonstrated improvements in productivity, where we can now erect a ton of steelwork in around 16 hours compared to Unit 1, which was 25 hours. As MD, it's a great privilege to see the growth in skills, knowledge, attitude and behaviour as this power station grows together around us. Further over to the left, you'll see the turbine hall for Unit 1, and by the end of this year, we expect to start constructing the large area for the turbine and the steam turbines. And beyond that, heading out to Wales, some 680 metres today, we've got the tunnel boring machine heading off to Wales, drilling a tunnel about 3.3 kilometres, so not far off a quarter done now. Great progress by those people and great progress in the team. Here on Unit 2, this is a nuclear island, but also behind me, down to the right, you can see construction of the turbine hall already started, and the tunnel preparation is already starting as well. So all around the site you can see today a lot of activity, a lot of production, but also a strong adherence to our social distancing principles.